one of the most interesting things about Roc Marciano to me, and I noticed the same thing about Freddie Gibbs too, is that he hides these stunning moments of just depth and pure emotion within 12 other lines about coke and being a pimp and just general braggadocio. But when these moments of depth show up, they make an even greater impact. They're a perfect demonstration as to why, no matter who you are, no matter what you're writing about, you have to have some sort of emotional through line in your art for the audience to really truly relate to you as an artist. There has to be some human element, some aspect of relatability that the audience can grab onto, even if those moments are fleeting, like in a lot of Roc Marciano's verses. Most of what Roc Marciano raps about, you and I probably can't relate to. What a lot of us can relate to is hustling to get by, dealing with trauma, loneliness, shame, fear, compromised morality, success, victory. These are all universal themes that make Roc Marciano's writing more than just pimp rap. It's art, it's the human experience. That's literally what he says on another one of the tracks of the album. So now that we understand the importance of having human moments in your track, no matter what the track is, let's see how Roc Marciano brilliantly crafts one of the best written moments on the Elephant Man's Bones. So this set of lyrics is actually from the title track, and it's probably my favorite set of bars on the entire album. So what's so interesting about these lines is that he completely drops his braggadocious persona and goes full human, and for one of the only times on the album expresses how he really feels. Let's look at the first line, for example. So he says his pen has pain in it. It's pretty different from the guy who, on the same album, says he doesn't even fear God and that the cardiologist can't hear his heart. And he says, I came into the entertainment business with this. Now, what's interesting to me about this line is that he doesn't say I came into the music business with this, because he's a musician, right? He says, I came into the entertainment business with this. I don't think that's just a throwaway line. And the reason why is because I think he's recognizing that at the end of the day, Roc Marciano, the person, is an entertainer. And he's playing a character. Now, sure, some of it may be based off real life, but he's playing a character. And that character is written from pain. So he's making his pain a business. And if you think that's a thematic leap, I promise you it's not, because in a different track, he literally says, I saw a lot as a child, I was traumatized, now it's monetized. But we see in the next two lines that that same pain is what leads Roc to assess that he can't trust anyone. He immediately equates any flirtation or romantic interaction with a woman as that woman just trying to get with her favorite musician, just viewing him as a product, right? So he's immediately pushing people away because of this trauma, because of this pain that has forced him to not be able to trust anyone. So when he says, like, I ain't got feelings, it hits so hard because he's actually for once being sarcastic. And he's actually saying, like, no, I do have feelings. I have wounds that not even the doctor could heal. So again, he's dropping the facade and he's just being completely human. Even if it's just for a few lines. But we're not done yet, because the first half of this stanza is really just setting up for the dramatic punchline in the next line. He builds up this tower of themes of isolation, trauma, not being able to trust people, longing for romantic connection, all of that leading up to the climax of the entire stanza. Two words, I'm ashamed. To me, when you think about it, that's as human as it gets. And this is all in the course of maybe 30 seconds. These are just a few lines in the course of a bunch of other different lines. So it's not like this whole track is this long emotional diatribe. No, it's a really fun underground rap song. But just these few sets of lines has so much emotional impact that it carries along the rest of the track. And in my opinion, it carries a lot of the album when you really want to think about it. So just think about that when you're writing your own tracks. Not every track has to be extremely emotional or extremely thematically deep. If you include, you know, just some snippets, some like clues to the listeners of what's really going on under the surface. So just something to think about. But anyways, let's keep going. So another thing that he does here, and this is a great tip to keep note of when you're writing, is that he doesn't use the next line just for emphasis. He builds upon that line too, so it has a dual purpose. So when he says, I'm hiding from the mirror like a vampire, yeah, it's for emphasis and, you know, like, that's clever, right? But instead of just leaving it there, he relates the vampire to him not having forever to correct all of his errors. Roc is like, can I do more with this? Can I go deeper with this metaphor? And what he comes up with, to me, is just brilliant and haunting note to end on, and it brings all of the human themes together and adds mortality into the mix. If you have moments like these in your track, where you take at four or five lines and you just really, really hone in on them, even if it takes a day, even if it takes a week, those are the kind of moments that separate the good tracks from the truly great tracks. So if you're working on your project and you feel like there's something missing, or you're trying to just add something else and you just don't know exactly what it is, maybe try just taking a few lines and just going in on them and leaving the rest of the song alone, and maybe letting that be a little bit lighter in terms of content. These are the kinds of things that separate good writers from truly great writers. It's like I said earlier in the video, if you really want to take your art to the next level, it has to have a human element or some aspect of relatability for the audience to grab onto. The harder you work at making that emotional through line narratively effective, the better your results are going to be when it comes to writing your own stuff. So to keep things concise, I'm going to leave it right here. If you like this video and you want to learn more about how to write like some of the best rappers and some of the best artists out there right now, definitely subscribe, because this is going to be my main form of content going forward. Be sure to like the video if you, you know, liked it. Let me know down below, what's your favorite part about Roc Marciano's writing? There's literally so much I didn't cover, so trust me, I probably will be returning back to Roc, because he is just such an amazing artist. I'm Dylan from Unknown Reviews. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.